She took her in custody.
Okay.
And brutally
beat her up.
Beat her up.
Okay.
To the point that it cracked her skull open.
Okay.
Then later on in the police station,
yeah,
because of
the injury,
hemorrhage in her brain,
yeah,
she collapses and passes away.
Okay.
And they don't tell you the entire story. But okay, whatever they tell you has puts a lot of focus on that footage only.
Okay.
They say, okay, it was because of natural causes, but that's,
yeah,
not
that's
the
what
case.
They were saying.
Listen to her,
yeah,
father, listen to her brother.
Yeah.
They are very brave and they're talking and they ask so many, yeah, questions. But
okay,
why the government is not answering, yeah, those questions?
And if you want to, so, actually feel the brothers, if you have a sister,
yes,
she's wearing her job,
yeah,
just
imagine,
imagine in here, someone,
yeah,
take her,
yeah,
job.
Yeah,
imagine the police does
and
that to your,
you
sister,
know, beat her up, mm, because she has the hijab. It's the same feeling,
yeah,
it's not right.
Okay, so as I've listened to you guys, like I didn't know some stuff. I really appreciate. Thank you for clarifying to me. As a Muslim man, what's the number one? I'm against the whole regime of Iran, period. Like as Muslims, Sunni Muslims, we're against that anyway. And number two, in Islam, actually to take a life, like there is no prescribed punishment for someone not wearing the hijab. Like if you look at the Sharia, there is no prescribed, like, prescribed punishment for adultery, for zina, for slander, for robbery, for apostasy. But when it comes to the hijab, there is, it doesn't mean it's not a sin, but there is nothing that says that you can kill somebody over hijab. This is a big fat lie, which is a different topic. I'm just clarifying, yeah?
The problem,
yeah,
is they kill people for a variety of,
exactly,
reasons.
Exactly, exactly.
This
is an excuse.
Because they are oppressing,
yes,
the society,
exactly,
right?
Yes.
They have their brutal police forces,
yes, yes,
to
yeah, trying to silence people. Yes.
Yeah.
So
no,
what
only
we're against is,
yeah,
the our politicians, our government.
Yes, yes.
We're not against anything other than that.
Yes.
They people, if,
yeah,
if someone, mm, would force or kill any woman in Iran,
yes,
for wearing hijab,
yes,
I would do the same for,
yes,
them. I would do exactly
not, yeah,
the,
you know, sometimes, you know, like in France, for example, yeah, like,
yeah,
the jab.
I would be absolutely,
exactly, like,
that.
It's just sometimes,
yeah,
you know what it is, we understand where you're coming from, somebody's,
no,
lost their life, at the end of the day, like Allah says in the Quran, if you take one soul, it's as if you kill the whole of humanity, and if you save one soul. So what we want to tell you guys, I know some of you guys are not Muslim, but the thing is, Islam is free from this. This has nothing to do with Islam.
That's,
I want to make that clear. I want to make that clear.
You know the behavior of these regimes.
Yes.
Is damaging the society.
Yes.
But you know who takes the damage even more than that?
Yeah.
Islam.
Yes, exactly.
Because they,
yeah,
do it in the name,
exactly,
of Islam.
Same,
so,
as ISIS. They,
so,
do it in our,
exactly,
name. I have to go and say, me, I'm sorry, I'm not,
yeah,
ISIS. I have to clarify
that's
myself 100
exactly
times.
That's exactly the same for,
exactly,
Iranians,
yes,
when we come to any other countries.
Yes,
all the
they think,
have to,
yeah,
say that I'm Iranian,
yes,
but I'm not with the,
exactly,
government.
Yes,
I'm,
yes,
not thinking about killing,
yeah,
other people.
Exactly.
Yeah, that's,
so
that's,
you share our pain, because,
exactly,
we go through the same thing.
That's the same.
We're doing, all we're doing is we're suffering at the hands of these people who have hijacked our religion.
Yeah.
Like
any,
for you guys, yeah,
anyone who's using their power,
yeah,
we have to be against them.
Yes.
No one,
yeah,
should be in power more than a period of time in, a,
yeah,
in any country.
Yeah.
You've been in power for 5 years. Thank you very much. Go away.
Mm.
Someone else should come in.
Yeah, yeah.
But the problem is, this man been in power,
yeah,
for more,
well,
than,
more
three,
than 30
three
years.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, imagine how corrupted is that government.
Mm-hmm.
Imagine all the money that they have,
yeah,
and how they are spending it. It's awful.
You can see all indications of a dictatorship and a totalitarian regime in Iran.
Mm.
All indications, and one of the massive ones, is a single person in power for more than 30 years.
Yeah.
He has all the power and resources in the country.
Okay, so you know one thing I wanted to touch up on, maybe it's relating to this, is that, you know, when we talk about freedom, so like for example, a person is free to wear the hijab or not to wear the hijab, just off topic a bit, when we talk about freedom, what do you exactly mean? Because like, I don't believe personally in this concept that you choose not to wear the hijab. I don't believe this exists. Like, I'll repeat again. I believe that you don't choose not to wear the hijab. You are forced not to wear the hijab.
By
whom?
Oh,
by whom?
Okay, good, good. So this is where I want to come in. Because,
by the,
okay, society.
Society.
Peer pressure.
Or maybe by the things that I've read, or
maybe
in the day,
maybe.
I think that, oh, I have a beautiful hair, I want to have it,
mm-hmm,
around me.
Yeah.
Okay?
Yeah.
You're absolutely right.
Yeah.
Because maybe 100 years later,
yeah,
women are going to shave their hair because it's more efficient.
So,
as simple as that.
It can be
anything. So, I absolutely agree. I am not wearing hijab at the moment,
yes,
because of all the things that happened in my life.
Okay, I understand. And I'm sorry that,
yeah,
happened. And whoever did this, I genuinely, on their behalf, to make you feel, like, I'll be honest with you, look, sometimes as Muslims, the Prophet, peace be upon him, said, I came for nothing but to perfect good character. Meaning, when
what's
you look...
What's the definition of good character?
Good. And so, for example, good character starts with Allah, God Almighty. Because some people say, this tree is God. We say that's having bad character with Allah.
I want to give you a tip.
Yes, please.
One tip, because I've been in court. I'm 41 years old. Okay. I've been had this in conversation a lot.
Yeah.
One thing that people get wrong is that if in a good intention, even in a brotherhood intention, they come and tell me and tell me, one day I'm going to say, okay, I'm going to raise it.
No, maybe
not.
No, exactly.
So even with the good intention, do not repeat the same message. I'm telling you.
Exactly, yes. Yeah. So what I'm
change it, give it other things.
Yeah.
Because I believe that people, they are, most people, they look for religion. They want to have a religion.
Of course, everybody.
It gives them with the happiness.
A purpose.
It calms them.
A purpose,
if they are having a stressful day.
Yeah.
Whatever reason. Yeah. They find it. So I don't have problems with people having religion.
Yeah, I know,
that's
I know.
Yeah. This one can be one of those.
Yes,
people.
Yes.
I don't mind.
Yeah.
But one tip really for you is that even by being kind, but repeating and repeating, that's not going to work.
Okay, good. So what I was saying, I wasn't saying that let's be kind and do the same thing.
Yeah.
What I was saying, in general, as Muslims, we should have good character. Period. Not about you wear hijab or not wear hijab. I'm just saying, in general, as Muslims, we are. This is where the I forgot the name, but basically we are the ones who are in the front. We are the ones that people judge Islam by. So it's very important for us to conduct ourselves in the right manner. But the thing what I was just saying after the sister as well is that I believe truly that for someone to say that they don't wear the hijab and they choose not to, I believe this is not true. And luckily, I'm talking off topic. I'm not talking about this issue, yeah? What I mean by that is, for example, there are a lot of women in this country or around the world, billions of them, who wear miniskirts. They get their nose done. They get their backside done. They get their breasts done. The question is, do they choose to do this? I say no. They are forced to do this.
That happens exactly to Islam as that. You know,
Islam to a side. Islam to a side.
We're going to say people, the
beauty industry, other women, men, society. There are many. There's a book on this.
But that happens to people that they have hijab as that.
Yes.
You are saying that they're not choosing it. It just happens.
No. Like for example.
They don't have freedom.
Yes. Why is it so difficult for my Muslim brothers to accept that people can think differently from them?
No, we accept that. Look, what I'm not saying that.
Miniskirt is not bad.
It's the hardest thing for you guys to accept that people can think differently.
Of course they do.
And choose not to wear hijab.
Of course, I'm not saying that.
You're having a very difficult time to accept that.
No, I accept that.
I don't believe that having a nose done job is bad as well. I don't think
if a woman, but sister,
no,
if a woman tries to get her nose smashed, this is not oppression. This is not oppression.
It is their body, their choice.
Okay, is it their choice when the industry and the beauty industry and the makeup industry?
I'm not gonna advertise. If my sister does it, I'm not gonna say don't.
No, I'm not saying that. We shouldn't hit anybody. What I'm saying is.
Sorry, my thing is gone.
Okay,
so
okay, no problem. Thank you very much, sister. Sorry, like just in a nutshell, guys. Like what happened was tragic. I don't want to twist, like, change the story. The point I was trying to make is this perception that we are under, that women who cover up are forced, but women that cover up are not forced. And this is a big fat lie. This is a big fat lie. You look at the beauty industry, $1 billion industry. Yeah? Now, just because somebody doesn't hit you on the head and go, don't wear the hijab, get your nose done, doesn't mean they are free. The point I'm trying to say is, which woman, why do they wake up in the morning and find the need to spend 2 hours doing makeup? Why do they find the need to wear 4-inch heels and it's so uncomfortable they have to take it off in cold weather? Why do they find the need to get their buttocks, their backsides done, and some of them die in the process? There was a Brazilian woman in Brazil, she got her bum done and she died. She literally sacrificed her life for that beauty. So the point I'm trying to say is this notion that Muslim women are oppressed and the Western woman or Iranian woman, whoever it may be, we choose to take it off. No, you don't. You are told to in a different way. And you think, no, you don't. Why do you go, like, by the way, anyone can dress up how they want to dress up in this country. The point I'm trying to make is this. None of us should see this, but you know, it pops up in front of you. In the winter, a woman wearing a miniskirt, you're thinking to yourself, did she really choose to? Did she wake up and say, it's freezing cold and I'm going to wear a miniskirt today? No, she does not. She's like, I think I look beautiful. men look at me, I'm in competition with other women, and the beauty industry and all of this, and I am willing to go and wear a miniskirt. That is oppression. Now, the same could be said about our sisters. Do they wear the hijab because they want to? No, they do it because they have to. Do I wake up for Fajr because I want to? Well, yeah, but I do it because I have to. It's not something I enjoy in the context where I'm like, it's hard, waking up for Fajr is hard. But I do it because I'm told to. Now you're going to say, well, what's the difference? You are told to, they are told to. The difference is this. I choose to follow the one that created me, and he deserves my worship, and it deserves me to obey him. However, the creation, the beauty industry, the men and the opposite gender and all these industries, they do not deserve me to listen to them. That is the difference. And that's the point I just wanted to make. And obviously it's sad what happened to the sister who passed away. And this is not from Islam. Nowhere in Islam does it tell you to execute or kill somebody because they do not wear the hijab. There is no capital punishment for this. Yeah, there isn't. Let's be real. Like, I'm an Orthodox Muslim. I should call my religion. You know, there is capital punishment for apostasy. Yeah, and I always say this, and I've got no problem with it. Yeah, in a legitimate Islamic country. But when women come to me and make it out as if they choose, like she said, I don't see any problem with getting my nose done. Can you imagine going under operation? When you get your nose done, your eyes start going, you know, after operation, your eyes are this big. Yeah, there can be confusions, complications. Yeah, you're telling me you are willingly to go there and get your nose done? No, you're not. I have family members, I know, so I don't want to get into detail. 3-4 of them have got their nose done. And I go to them and go, she done it, okay. Why did you do it? Oh, I done it because it looked good on her. Okay, so why did you do it? Oh, because it's good. Come on, man, don't come to me with this. I'm so sorry. So I don't buy that notion of we are free to get our nose smashed in, bleed, cut it open, turn it to a different shape. No, you don't. You do it because of the standards that are put on you, the pressure that's put on you. If anybody disagrees, I'm happy to have a dialogue. If not, I'm going to end my conversation here. Since you guys have been listening, if you want to give me £10 each, I'll appreciate it. I'm joking. Till next time. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.